Good afternoon, everyone. This is Ben Busby. I am the Genomics Outreach Coordinator and Bioinformatics Training Lead for NCBI. I am joined here by Peter Cooper, who is the Strategic Communications Coordinator for NCBI. We'll be talking about downloading human genome sequence, variants, and annotations from NCBI. Today, I'm going to do most of this as a live demo, but I've prepared a set of slides covering most of what I'm going to talk about as a backup. Those slides are available at this link, go.usa.gov, etc., as well as slideshare.net if you go to my page. On both of those resources, there are quite a few other slides and presentations, so feel free to check them out, or you can always Google for NCBI webinars. If most of you are like me, you probably start your search with Google. This is what we find most users do. And one thing I might Google for is NCBI Human Genome Resources. I can open up an incognito tab just so I don't get autocomplete. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And what I might Google for is NCBI Human Genome Resources. I don't know why my autocompletes are still showing up incognito, but that is not an issue for today. So the first link I see is Human Genome Resources at NCBI. We modified this page about a year ago. We've put a whole bunch of new bells and whistles in. And what we've done recently is moved up the download section of the page and made it easier to use. So one thing you could do on this page, you could search for human genes, and it'll send you to the NCBI gene page. You could also click on the ideogram to access the genome data viewer in that region. But what I want to talk about today is downloading various sequences as well as other NCBI resources through this simple to use table. So if you want the latest reference genome sequence in either GRCH38, which is the new version of the human genome, about 30% of you are using that at this point, and about 70% of you are still using the old human genome, GRCH37. If you're interested in the differences between GRCH38 and 37, I would highly encourage you to check out the Genome Reference Consortium webpage. You do that just by Googling Genome Reference Consortium. You can check out the Genome Reference Consortium. It'll tell you all kinds of things about GRCH37 and 38. Anyway, on this page, this gives you quick, direct links to download the reference genome sequence. So this is going to be the FASTA file. It's gzipped, but that should be accessible to most of you, as well as the GFF3 file. So here you can get all of the annotations that NCBI has for that file. Some of you may just want RefSeq transcripts. So these are just the mRNA sequences that are transcribed from the GRCH38 human genome, the ones we're fairly certain are transcribed. You can get all protein sequences. This is a protein FASTA. You can also get a VCF for ClinVar. A lot of people search for the ClinVar VCF. This is a very quick way to get it, as well as the VCF for dbSNP. I would make one word of caution. The dbSNP VCF is rather large, as you might expect, especially since in dbSNP release 150, we just doubled the number of RS numbers. And finally, dbVar, which I think is really increasing in significance. This is a database of structural variants, and those structural variants really have big consequences both in other technical work with the human genome as well as clinical reporting consequences. However, some of you may want API access to this kind of information for the human genome, for other genomes, and as many of you are probably aware, we have an API known to most people as eUtils, and we've made a command line wrapper for that API called eDirect. Still, it can sometimes be a little tricky to use to make scripts for the command line wrapper. So one thing we've done is we've made a little cookbook on GitHub for scripts using that command line wrapper. So, and the amazing thing to me is that we've made this interactive. So if you have a GitHub account, you can put in issues for things that you might want to do with our metadata API, or you can just scroll down, copy some of these scripts, and modify them. So for example, if you wanted not just human, but any taxonomic designation, you could grab this script and simply just modify the query sequence, and that would give you whatever taxonomic designation you wanted. Now, it does say here for larger sets of data, it may fail with a large number of arguments. We find empirically that caps out about 50,000. So searches for more than 50,000 items probably won't work so well in this context. And you can do lots and lots of similar things. If there's something you want to do with API metadata crossing Ncbi databases, try it. And if you can't figure it out, once again, put an issue in the eDirect cookbook. So the last thing I want to show you today is how to actually look at the human genome at Ncbi. And for that, what I would do is scroll down to the view portion of the page, and I'm going to load up a resource we have called the Genome Data Viewer. And this really shows a lot of Ncbi resources at the same time. So here I can show lots of RefSeq transcripts for particular gene loci. I can show SNPs in ClinVar, dbSNP obviously, and then I can also see RNA-seq coverage, and that's pretty neat. If I want to, I can use the tracks menu to split that out into various tracks. But one thing I really like about this browser is I can go ahead and search for a disease or a gene name, and it'll go ahead and load that up. So here I've searched for APOE. I can see the RefSeq isoforms for APOE right here, and I can see related genes here. You can also upload your own data or add tracks as you wish. If you want to learn more about this type of stuff, we have featured webinars. There are also fact sheets. Many people find these very helpful. Or once again, Google for Ncbi webinars. Again, you can directly download the latest version of the human genome sequences, FASTA, as well as annotation and associated files right here at the Ncbi Human Genome Resources page. And with that, I am happy to stop and take any questions that you may have. So somebody asked where you can find the common list of variants reported in all Ncbi resources. And I would say that if you're looking for short variants, variants under 50 nucleotides, you're going to want to look in dbSNP. And in fact, for the dbSNP GRCH38 release, that's really going to be a VCF of all of those variants. Similarly, if you're interested in structural variants, you're going to want the latest dbVar release. And like I said, both of those resources are available right here on the Human Genome Resources page. So there's some specific questions. I will take a look at them, and we may answer some of them offline. Yeah, we'll actually put them in the documentation for the webinar. All right, we're going to go ahead and wrap it up. Thank you very much for your time, and I hope you have an excellent rest of the day.